Hello, hello, hello. This is Rupesh and you're watching CBP Nerds video series on STL series, and this topic is not a very big topic. It's just a internal topic. It's container inside container. So many people think that container inside container, what does it mean? So this is how it looks like. So one vector containing another vector, okay? So some of you might be wondering, why am I taking this topic? So it will be very clear once you will see the problem. So let's look at the problem. The problem is you have this tree and it is looking something like this. Okay, so this is a tree. And now if I'm telling you what would be the data structure you will take to just quickly solve the problems related to the tree. I mean, you are going to some competition exams and then you have to write some programs, right? So if you are really taking linked lists and all that, then it will really take so much of time to actually build your corpus and you go for your solution. No, what you will do, you will use something like this. I mean, this is what I used to do and millions of people are doing this. So you might be thinking how I will solve this problem using this vector of vector. So let's quickly see that. See, you know that if you are using only one vector, then it would look something like this. Correct? Now you'll have 0th position, 1st position, 2nd position and 3rd position. But this is vector of vector. So one element itself is another vector. So let's tilt this in this way. So it will be very easy for us. Then let me just create it like this. Each and every element of this vector is actually holding another vector. Okay, this one is holding another vector. And like this, everyone is holding their own vectors. Okay, so these all are holding the vectors. So now when you say that from 1 you can go to 2 and 3, then this is your 0th position, this is your 1st position. So you'll say that from 1 I can go to 2 and 3, that's it. And if there is some another line going from 1 to something else, you will put that here. Okay, and now see, from 2 you can go to 4 and 5, right? So this is your 2. From 2 you can go to 4 and 5, correct? So this is how you will create your data structure, and it is really very easy when you will see this program here. So now quickly see which one is the biggest one. See, this 8 is the biggest one. So at max you can go till 8, right? So 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. So this is your 7 and this is 8, so total it is going to be 9, correct? So see here, we have this vector of vector, we will call this a tree, and then this is edge. So this particular thing, this arrow, is called edge. I have written the program in such a way that whatever edge I will give, it will resize this tree that much. I mean, this is the length of this tree. I mean, how many edges will be there? So for now we'll say that there will be 8 edges. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, but we'll say 8, okay, so that we can put this 8 in the end. So we'll put 8 here, and notice this, we are using resize, not reserve, okay? So 4 will take input, N1 and N2. N1 is the source and N2 is the destination. So if this 1, 2, 3 is there, then the input would be like this, 1, 2, 3, 2, 2, 4, 2, 2, 5, and then 3, 2, 6, and then 3 to 8. Okay, so this is your source and this is your destination. So we will take these inputs and tree N1. This is very important. See, N1. So using tree, you are directly going to that particular position. So initially, let's suppose you are giving this 1 to 3. Okay, so this N1 is 1 and N2 is 3. So 1 push back 3. So this, you are pushing back 3 here. Let's suppose this, there is nothing inside this. So you're just pushing back in this array, sorry, vector. So 3 has come here. Now you will say 1 to 2. Oh, sorry, 1 to 2 is missing here. So you will say 1 to 2. So again, we'll push 2 here. Okay, like this. So after pushing all these things, I mean the edges, your vector would look something like this. So using container inside container, see, it is not limited to the vector inside vector. You can insert anything inside this vector. Vector can contain map, can contain sets, multi-set, ordered set, unordered set. So many options are there. Actually, if you will mix all the containers with other containers, you will find that combination is superb. Okay, and by this video, I just wanted to show you this example with this simple example. And then this is just a range-based for loop. So if I will use tree and I will apply a range-based for loop, so I will iterate over this vector first and I will get first vector. So line by line, we can print this. Okay, I'll show you how this will look like. So our entries would be 1 to 3, 2 to 4 and all that. So let's compile this. Okay, now it is asking me how many edges, and how many edges are there, if you remember correctly? 6. So 6 plus 1, 7. We can give 7 edges, but it's okay. We can give 6 also, right? So 6, hit enter. Yeah. So what was that first edge? 1 to 2, sorry. And then 1 to 3. Then 2 to 4, 2 to 5. And then 3 to 6. And then 3 to 8. Hit enter. So see, we are getting 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8. And if I will show you this, see, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8. Okay, this was our vector, right? 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8 after this tree. So you can clearly see that 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8 is coming after this output. Okay, so this is very easy and it will make sense when you will do the practice with this. Okay, so don't forget, one container can be combined with another container and it will be a magic if you will use it correctly. And it will be very easy for programming competition. That's why I use all these things, so that your main focus is to solve the problem, not actually think what data structure or how you should code. Okay, your focus should not be on that. So if you have any doubt, let me know that. I'll try to fix it. And thanks for watching, guys. I hope I'll see you in the next videos. Bye bye.